Hello everybody and welcome back once again to Let's Play Medieval 2 Total War Kingdoms, the Byzantine campaign. Yes, it's been almost a month since the last update. What with holidays and work cropping up and all that sort of thing, it's been a little while. But we're back. We're back and now we're ready to press on with this campaign because we turned a rather interesting point last time we left off. We defeated the Venetians. We were preparing immensely for the Venetian threat and they were wiped out rather quickly and easily. All our preparations were in vain? I don't think so. It is better to be over-prepared than under-prepared. Anyway, they have been vanquished, which leaves us now with a boatload of troops up near the Constantinople region that we can use to our advantage. And what I propose to do is to merge them into two armies. We have one family member here, Mavros. We have one here.
Your orders, noble one.
This other guy, whose name is awkward to pronounce. And they are going to merge into two armies. One army will move down through the lands here, assisting in reinforcing the Dorylaeum region. Because once we have wiped out this final Turkish general, we are then going to amass the forces together and march round here, taking these four Turkish lands with those armies. The second army from the Constantinople area, we are going to take it on a boat all the way over to here, which we might lose to the Turks very shortly, recapture it, and then we are going to head south and capture these two settlements with that particular army. And the third and final army at Trebizond will be heading sort of round about here, taking Caesarea and this town down here. So it will be a three-pronged attack against the Turks, hopefully with no hitches. And then we can be on the upper hand, on the upper foot, if that is such a saying. On the front foot, that is a foot that we will be marching on, yes, the front foot. Not the upper foot. That doesn't make sense. Unless you have foot halfway up your leg, of course. Anyway, so that is the plan with the armies. With the agents, we had the Splinter Cell here, the Diplomat Spy and Assassin, trying to do their best to hinder Lachin Kavur. It's not working, so we're going to have to take him down with brute force. So I shall be retraining my assassin up with slightly easier targets now, because he's obviously had a few fumbles. So first of all, we'll take out this imam here.
Named it.
Good night. And God bless you. And he moves up in skill.
Who has displeased you?
Excellent. It's a good start. There is another assassin. Oh, another assassin. There is another imam over here who is causing some kind of grief somewhere in my lands, which I don't like. So he shall fall too, to Andronicus the Mighty.
Yes, Lord.
This spy is just keeping an eye on this army, and this diplomat.
Yes, my lord.
Was trying
you are lucky
to bribe.
We receive you at all, infidel.
The answer, I'm afraid.
Our discussions come to a close.
Is no. I am actually training another, or I should be training another diplomat here in Constantinople. He shall board the ships here, and they shall sail forth. Round they go, down to Jerusalem, where we shall obtain trade rights. Because, as it has been suggested, it is a crime that we are not trading with these people just yet. And then we shall head down to Egypt and get trade with those people. Yes, it's not ideal to be, you know, in the good graces of the Egyptians. We will ultimately be fighting with them at some point. But for now, whilst we have the opportunity, we should be making use of as much trade as possible. So that is the plan with my units. In terms of construction, I have taken down the tax rates in some of my lands, and I have we are now switching priorities. It is no longer a money-making priority that is our primary concern, but now we are trying to promote growth. So down with the taxes, building more public growth buildings, and trying to increase our profits through increased population, rather than taxing the hell out of our populace. I'm sure they'll be happy with the rather kind-hearted ways now that we have turned to. But apart from that, everything has been done off-camera, so I will press on with the end turn and see what happens next. As imams converge upon my lands, what are you trying to do? We have, okay. Yeah, nothing but a pain. Oh, we have been gifted with 2,500 flora. I thank you. Thank you, you council of noble chaps. So kind of you to donate some money to my affairs. We shall need it, no doubt. Because we are in the red in a lot of these things, but it was a temporary blip, I am sure. Alright. So, on the boat, Romanus of Zichna, you have been given your instruction. I want you to get yourself down quickly as possible to Jerusalem. Where is Jerusalem? It's about halfway down here, somewhere around about here. So you're going to board all the way over there. And it should
we shall continue tomorrow, my lord.
Be slightly quicker than walking, so he's going to go around and get that trade right for us. Which leaves us with another situation. Where are you?
What is the name?
I want him dead.
Am I taking down a person or a place?
I want him dead, please. I want his head paraded around my living room. Stuck on a plaque on a wall like a bear. You know, one of them bear head things, trophies, yes. Only it would be the head of him. Rather sick, isn't it? And this... Oh! I was going to say they don't seem to be interested in taking Sinope, but it seems they're just moving a larger army towards it instead. Well, isn't that marvellous? Yes. It's only a small garrison. Why do you feel the need
to... Your corpse will be thrown to the dog.
Crash down the gates.
Let me strike, my lord.
Let me strike.
Approaching, my lord.
Of course, as we well know... Oh! Antioch. It seems Antioch are taking a dislike to the Turks, and they are actually marching towards Turkish lands too. This is good. Yes. A battle on many fronts. For the Turks will not be profitable. So it seems that okay. All right, so he's ready to go now. He's got a full stack army.
Yes. Command me.
Pretty much we're leaving the entire place empty as hell, but that doesn't bother me because we're off on our merry travels. Blueface, well, you can recruit some petty, some archers. Couple of archers, some spearmen. You know, you'll be fine in my absence. Don't worry
Your
about
will.
It. Off we go.
Onward. We continue tomorrow,
so
my lord.
He is going to be marching down towards here. I better be careful because if I march into the lands of
name thy enemy, lord.
Antioch, without getting military access, they might take offence. But it's too late. This guy has got ahead of himself there and might just cause us some diplomatic problems, but hey-ho.
Your orders?
One's man's clumsiness is another's fortune.
Command me.
All right.
Yes.
So he's moving down.
Here, my lord.
Don't quite have enough.
Yes, lord.
To mess around. Okay, so we need in this army, we're taking out some of the troops that are undermanned here.
Command me.
Replacing them with orders, full stacks.
Yes.
For now, take them out.
Mark.
There we go.
Orders,
so
one.
We could do with another couple of archers here. So we have plenty.
Yes.
There
orders.
We go.
Move out.
We could do
Finding
with
forces,
probably
lord.
Another couple of horses, Byzantine cavalry, Byzantine lancers. So we could probably do with some more.
Command me.
Orders. There we go.
We have
1, 2, 3 spears, and that should do us. Maybe go for one more set of spearmen.
Yes.
Find and then some of these Varangian
my lord.
Guard chaps. And some of these.
Your Majesty. Combining forces, my lord.
Right.
An honor to serve.
An honor to serve, indeed.
We march.
Build me a boat, please. I have business to attend to. Fire ship? Yes, please. That'll do. Thank you very much. We are going to go and hot foot it all the way over here. because this is a critical situation. I do not want Sinope to fall into the enemy hands for longer than necessary. I should not have my subjects, you know, subjected to their heinous rule. So we need to get over there quickly. So he...
Yes, Lord.
Prausinos of Lazica is heading along the northern shore to try and quell this little insurrection that has cropped up here of Turkish troops, and he shall do so in a rather elegant style. Skillful as ever.
Who do I face?
The rest of these troops will merge in
Let
here.
Strike, my lord.
Although he needs to... he's got a little bit of raggy, taggy, battered and bruised selection. They will then start to amass, and then they will head down here, helping out the Emperor, who requires some reinforcements. So...
Your will.
How much do we need? We need one more horse, I think.
Orders.
From what I can remember, we need one more horse, which is going to be these Scythicons.
Orders. March!
Is that right? No, that's wrong. That's wrong. I've miscalculated.
Yes!
Go back!
Lurking on me.
You blasted Scythicons. You have totally lost the plot. We have one Armenian archer. We have two Trebizond archer. We need one more archer.
Command me. March.
And we need... We got one spear. We got one spear. One spear, one spear, one spear. Could probably do with about two more spears. There's one. And that'll have to do because we only have one. And then we could just do with three more sets of infantry.
Yes.
There we go.
Move out.
This army will then commence forth Operation Crush on Turks. Yes, it's going to be glorious. It's going to be glorious indeed. There we go. As we then take him inside,
Orders.
Keeping an eye on the situation here. And
Your will, Your Majesty.
It's a rather raggedy band of troops, but it's enough to defend against this. And they can wait patiently for this other army to come down. So that's that. So we have how much? 5,000 to spend, right?
Yes.
So we're just going to do a bit of construction work here, and we do have plenty of retraining to do, but we're not going to bother with that just for now. We're going to build the most essential buildings for now, and we have a brothel here. It's only cheap, might as well build it. Normal tax rate is the lowest I'm going to go. Unless there's public order problems, because I am not that kind. I am not about to give everybody too easy of a time. I do want some money in my coffers. That's building a town hall. That needs a leather tanner, which we won't build for now. It's not compulsory. Town. Oh, I've pressed the wrong button. Sorry. Okay, Sinope. I wasn't going to upgrade Sinope to a stone wall just yet, in case it does fall. I don't want to give our attackers a potential advantage of stone walls when they take it, so we're going to ease off that until we have got the area secure. Trebizond, it's a castle, it's recruiting some troops to garrison it. We do have plenty of building work to do, and we'll start with the most cost effective, which is mines, I would assume. And that's quite a big chunk of cash out of the old treasury. Town Watch in... Well, we're building the walls first. Abydos, we're building Town Hall. Smyrna. We could do with some more farming, probably. Maybe some an Orthodox chapel, but it's a little bit pricey. Rhodes is getting its land clearance finally. And we move back to Constantinople, the home of our mighty empire. So this is a good building. It apparently gives conversion effect amplification bonus of 50%. So is that across our lands? Because if it is, it might be quite useful, seeing as how most of these will be Muslim owned. I think a little bit of a bonus to conversion, religious conversion, would be beneficial in the long run. So we're going to build that right now. So everything is done with our agents, with our units. I think it is time for us to fight. Emperor Manuel and his brother, Prince Stephanos, are going to march out. They have quelled and quashed and battered and bruised one Turkish army. Let's see if we can finish the job and then counterattack and start to expand our empire in peace.
My lord, should we spare any of them?
Well, bugger me sideways. We don't have enough legs. Okie doke, next turn it will be. I'm actually quite tempted to wait until this army is actually on its way down, and we could sort of pincer it in and take him down with two full stacks. He wouldn't stand a bloody chance, and we'd probably suffer less losses. Interesting. We'll see if he attacks us. If he doesn't attack us, we might just sort of do a wee tango, a wee jig around, we move away, we move towards, just to get him a bit on edge, you know, put the frighteners on him a bit. I believe we're done. I always like to double check these things. We still have blockaded their port down here. Is it serving a purpose? I don't know, but we're going to take out one extra ship and blockade that port as well.
Leaving the rest of the fleet, my lord.
You have two ports blockaded now.
We control access to this port now, my lord.
Cutting their income slightly. Just because we can. And that should do. I would actually like map information with the Antiochans, if that is how you pronounce the collective of those people.
Yes.
But we shall sort that out later. Oh, here we go. Oh dear. It was coming, it was not a shock, this.
My
this
lord,
is not
the
a
enemy
shock.
Lay siege. What shall we do?
What I don't like, take the rebel settlement of Corum. What I don't like to see is that they actually had some troops meandering down here, just because Heraclea is actually fairly under-defended as well. So we're going to have to be careful.
Yes, my lord.
That we don't lose more.
Plotting course,
noble lord.
Than necessary here.
Yes, my lord. Plotting course now, my lord.
There would actually be some benefit of dropping the troops off here and then having them walk the rest of the way to Sinope so that we can sort of weed out any stray Turkish armies rather than them get behind us. I might actually do that.
Yes, lord. Yes. Your orders?
Okay, too many movement points required for this turn. A few buildings have been built. We have a new family member. And we're getting in the green, slightly. And we're besieged. Well, stranger things have happened. Okie dokie.